Hello everyone, this is John Wright from geniusescreed and welcome to the 13th lecture of the HYSYS training series. Introduction recovery of NGL from natural gas. It's quite common in natural gas processing, just like we discussed in the last time, and recovery is usually done for various reasons, such as to meet a seal specification, maximize liquid recovery, and etc. We also talk about how HYSYS can model a different range of configurations, different column configurations. In these NGL plants, there are three columns, which is a De-Methanizer, De-Ethanizer, and De-Propanizer. The first of which was done in the previous lecture. The remaining two will be continued, be modeled in this particular lecture. The learning outcome still the same as the previous lecture, and also the prerequisite the same. Now the problem statement here, it says a pump is used to move the De-Methanizer bottom product to the sixth stage of the De-Ethanizer, which is modeled as a 16 stage distillation column. 14 trays in the column plus the reboiler and the condenser, making it 16 stages. Now it operates as 400 psi. Now the objective of this column is to produce a bottom product that has a ratio of ethane to propane of 0.01. Then using the given data, that's in the next slide, the data is in the next slide, simulate the above process. So here's the data we're giving: the pump outlet pressure, the condenser type, the pressures, the temperature estimates, then specifications. So let's go to our HYSYS and see what we can do. Since we are starting from the 12th lecture, so we just click on this. So let's let that load. It's loading. Okay, I think we are set. So let me just minimize this a bit. I hope it's still clear. Okay, so first thing, the product statement said a pump was used. So here is a pump. Then the distillation column, which is here. So let's model the pump. Let's call this pump. The inlet will be the bottom DC1 bottom, that's the methanizer bottom product. The outlet will be the DC2 feed. The energy, let's call this pump horsepower. And let's come to our worksheet. It says the pump outlet is 405. Okay, pump outlet pressure. You can just pause the video here so that you can get all this together. So the pressure here, 405. Okay, 405 PSIA, 405 PSIA, done. So the pump has been completely modeled. So now let's come to our installation column. Let's call this DC2. The condenser energy is true. Let's call it DC2 condenser Q. The condenser type was partial. Let's call this excuse me DC2 overhead. let's call this DC2 distillate. Okay, then call this DC2 reboiler Q, and the bottom liquid with DC2 bottom. We are told it has 14 trays. Then the inlet is the DC2 feed, which enters at the sixth stage. I think we are good to go. So we click on next, regular HYSYS reboiler, next. Now, under pressures, we're giving the condenser pressure to be 395 PSIA. Pressure drop was 5 PSI. As the condenser pressure drop, and the boiler pressure was given to be 405. So next, our temperature estimate, we are giving the condenser to be 25 degrees Fahrenheit, and the boiler to be 200. Next, then finally the reflux ratio was given to be 2.5. The distillate rate, which is also the liquid rate, was going to be 0, and the vapor rate was going to be 320 kilogram mole. So done. This is done. We can come to the monitor here. We can run. Now, this has been. We are done with the simulation. Let's go back to our slide. Now, we asked what is the flow rate of C2 and C3 in the de-ethanizer bottom product, and the ratio of C2 to C3. So let's go back to our simulation specs. We asked for the molar flow at the bottom, so we can add specs. Coulomb component flow, let's call this C2. At the bottom, that's the C2 bottom. Capacity is 18. Excuse me, so we add another one for C3 components flow. Add C3, let's call this C3 stream at the bottom, C2 bottom. That's us for C3. Then we can add C2, C3 too. Come in. And the ratio C2 over C3. So let's go. So we add spirit, but now we are adding a fraction, C2 over C3. Bottom, which is the boiler, liquid mole fraction. Okay, I'm sorry, let's delete this. It's supposed to be a ratio rather. Sorry, component ratio. aspect. So let's say this is C2 over C3. Mole fraction liquid, the numerator will be C2, which is ethane, the denominator will be C3, which is propane. I think that's that. So we can come back to our monitor and we can see the value here of C2. This is the flow of C2 in the bottom product. This is for C3, this is C2 over C3. This is C2 over C3. So let's go back to our problem statement. What is the flow rate of C2 and C3 in the de-ethanizer, which we've done in the de-ethanizer bottom product, and also the ratio C2 over C3, which we found. But now the objective of this column is to produce a bottom product that has a ratio of ethane to propane of 0.01. So we have to change the C2 over C3 spec to 0.01, which is this. So first change that, we have to make one of these active, inactive, then make this active. Let's remove this overhead vapor rate, since we have to calculate that overhead vapor rate, then select this. It says we have not specified the value. The value is supposed to be 0.01. So done. We've successfully run it. So the new overhead vapor rate is 221.7 kilogram mole per hour. So that's that for the first part. Excuse me. Okay, so let's go to the next problem statement. We're done with this. Now, the next problem statement. The bottom product of the de-ethanizer passes through a valve that reduces its pressure to 245 psi before being fed into the 11th stage of the depropanizer, which is modeled as a 25-stage distillation column with 24 strays in the column plus the reboiler. Note that a total condenser does not count as a stage. Now it operates as 235 psi. Okay, with the given data, which is data in the next slide, simulate the process above with two process objectives for the column. Okay, so let's simulate, then we'll come back to the objectives. Now this is the data given. So you can pause this video while we simulate so that you can have a hold of this data. So let's go back to HYSYS. We are told a valve was used to reduce the pressure. So let's call this the inlet will be DC2 bottom and the outlet will be the DC3 feed. Now worksheet, we are told that the pressure was 245 psi. Can now bring our distillation column here. Okay, it's a 25 stage with 24 trays Then the inlet stream would be the DC3 feed entering at the 11th stage. Okay, you can call this DC3 condenser cube. We have a total reflux here. So we can call this DC3 distillate. We can call this the DC3 boiler Q. We can call this DC3 bottom. That's all. Let's call the column DC3, distillation column 3. Yeah, I think we are good on this page. We can move to the next page now. Regular HYSYS reboiler. Now the condenser pressure was given to be 230 psi. I can't seem to find PSI. Okay, found it. Then the reboiler pressure was meant to be 240 PSI. The condenser pressure drop was 5 PSI. They're not giving the reboiler pressure drop, so we just leave it. To the next page, the condenser temperature estimate is 100 degree Fahrenheit. That of the boiler is 250. Okay, the reflux ratio was 1 to the molar flow basis. The liquid rate, that's the distillate. 100 kilogram per hour. So done. We've successfully modeled the process, so we can come to monitor to see this then run. Okay, we successfully modeled the propanizer. So let's go back to our slides and see the objectives. So now the first objective is that the overhead product contains no more than 1.5 mole percent of IC4 and NC4. Then also the concentration of propane in the bottom should be less than 2 mole percent. So let's come to spec and add those specs. First was a mole fraction, right? Let's see. IC4 and NC4 stage at the distillate. That's at the product, so it should be the condenser liquid. So we add the IC4 and the NC4. We also add another spec for the, come, let me check it, for propane at the bottom stage. So fraction add spec, this should be propane C3 at watch stage, should be the bottom stage, which is the boiler. More fraction as that. So component should be propane. come back to the monitor. Now we're told that it should be 1.5. This should be 1.5, that's 0.015 mole percent. Then this should be 0.02 mole percent from the problem statement. That those are the objective. Overhead product contains no more than 1.5 mole percent of both these components, that's the I butane and N butane. Then the concentration of propane in the bottom product should be less than 2 mole percent, which we just specified in HYSYS. So now we can untick these two and work with the objectives. So we are done. It recalculated the reflux ratio to be 1.86 and the distillate rate to be 113.5 kilogram mole per hour. So I think that is all we have to do in this lecture. The video is a bit long. So that's that. This is everything we need to do. The NGL has been successfully, the NGL plant has been successfully modeled in HYSYS, and all the values we need have been found. So that's that for that, and that should be the end of this simulation. Now, I really hope you've learned today, and please remember to practice. If you learned something, give this video a thumbs up. You can make comments if you have any problem, or just send us a mail. Would respond as swiftly as you can. Once again, my name is Ongo John. Thank you very much for listening.